Good afternoon, and welcome to St. Louis Church. Today we celebrate the third Sunday of Easter. Let us sing together number 691, Lift Up Your Hearts. Please stand.
Sisters, as together we begin these sacred mysteries, we seek anew God's guidance and healing in our lives, imploring anew His strength and joy. Lord Jesus, you are always the Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the source of our hope for eternal life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, today you are the bread of life for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We adore you, we glorify you.
May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One, and ask that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments, are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord.
Sisters, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of bread. While they were still speaking about this, he stood in their midst and said to them, Peace be with you. But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. Then Jesus said to them, Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, that it is I myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see I have. And as Jesus said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, Have you anything here to eat? They gave him a piece of baked fish. Jesus took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. The Gospel of the Lord. One of the things that I've discovered in life is that it's easy to talk about someone when they're not in the room. I don't know if that's a discovery you've made in life yet, but it just seems that if that person is not around, then a conversation ensues. But what happens if that person pops in unexpectedly? I think we've all experienced situations like that, and there's that awkward silence. Even if you did not say anything by contributing to the conversation, you sort of are embarrassed. And the one who just walks in is no dummy. Depending on the person, they might ask what's going on, or they might just go and just sit in a chair or maybe their workplace. Jesus does exactly that with his friends today. And when he pops in as they're talking about him, there is this silence, but it's a bit complicated because they know what they have done. They're very much afraid of being scolded by Jesus, and they are aware that they made promises, but were not able to or willing to fulfill those promises. What is Jesus going to do? What is he going to say? They're rooted in their insecurities, just as many of us are rooted in our own insecurities. Think of how you'd feel if you walk in the room and you know they've been talking about you. Jesus is rooted in the Father. And everything that Jesus has comes to him from the Father. Look at what he does today. Peace be with you. Why are you hard of heart? Can't you see that it's me? Look at my hands. Look at my feet. Come and touch. Is there something here that I can nibble on? Instead of letting them keep their distance, always Jesus is inviting us to enter into his space, which is another way of saying of entering into his life. He knows what we're afraid of. He's very much aware of the burdens that we carry. He knows what embarrasses us. He understands the shame of our lives. He's very much aware of what we have done and of what we have said, but he's also very much aware of what we are able to do. In spite of their fear and awkwardness at this moment, Jesus invites each one of them, as he invites us today, to enter into his life, to enter into his joy. And we enter the joy that is the resurrection of Jesus by acknowledging and being very much aware that the strength of the good news has everything to do with the simple truth that you and I are loved and forgiven by our God. Those are the gifts that Jesus offers over and over. And these are gifts that he's generous with. And those gifts are always available because of his great mercy and the concern and the care that he has for each one of us. He is never indifferent, but always concerned and always very close. And we need to understand that what this forgiveness and mercy is all about, this tremendous love that overflows, has everything to do with the simple truth of the gospel that out of death comes life. A life that does not disappear the day that we die. And that's the work of the Good Shepherd, to bring us into that light, that we might experience that peace. And that peace can become the source of our own joy and the strength of what our lives are all about. But it does require that we allow ourselves to be loved and to welcome the forgiveness that is given. There is never any magic when Jesus works. He gives, but do we receive? And if we do receive, it's not so that we can feel good about ourselves. And for many people, that's as far as it goes. We receive this love, this mercy, so that we in turn can share that same love and mercy with all those that God has placed in our lives. We are meant to be the conduits of what the resurrection is all about. Men, women, and children who know not only how to receive, but also to share what is entrusted to us, not just for a moment, but for all of eternity. Now, for many of us, we know this, and we make it the truth of our lives that we are loved and forgiven. And that is true, but it is not enough. Out of death comes a life that does not disappear when we die. Which means, if we welcome the gift of this mercy that is fully revealed in the person of Jesus, a mercy that is our first experience of being loved and healed by our God, then the simple truth of all of our lives, which we need to repeat day in and day out, is this. We do not belong to ourselves. We belong to the God who has called Jesus from death and darkness into this light that we are privileged to stand in. And we need to make sure that we understand who we belong to, so that the unity of our lives might truly be of service always to the gospel. This good news that our world hungers for, and as the only remedy that brings peace to the human heart. Just as Jesus would do nothing without the Father, so we are called to live our lives always enfolded in the life of God, so that in all things we can truly be a witness of this light that is revealed by the open heart of Jesus, a light that calls us to trust, and a life that makes available all of the gifts of God, so you and I, in all circumstances, will have the joy of the gospel and the strength that flows from the open heart of Jesus. together for a profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Jesus was made known in the breaking of the bread. Our minds and hearts are open as together we pray.
Let the church be ever thankful for the gifts of the earth and the graces that flow from the real presence of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders revere the sanctity of life from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in a prison of isolation be welcomed and comforted by the hospitality of a loving community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this congregation, united in love and service, be perfected in the love of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our newly baptized Liliana Rain Hembry always receive the loving and joyful support of our parish community, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our young people will have an increased awareness of the closeness of the Lord as they discern their vocation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God welcome all who have died into the joys of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we remember the special intention of this Mass, Leonard Kelly, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, hear us as stewards of your Easter mysteries. This we offer in the name of Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go now in peace.